Hello students, so we are meeting after so long and I was very much I was waiting for you and I was waiting for you and me how we are going to interact, but unfortunately it is not possible now because of the present situation. You all are aware about it, but anyway we can talk together and we can interact together by this virtual mode. So this is for the first time for me to record the lecture, so I hope you all will forgive me if any mistake occurs, huh? We are older people, not smarter like you. Okay, now come to the topic. So today I'm going to talk about immune system. So in your syllabus it is given as a introductory topic, so that you are aware of the immune cells which are involved in the immune system, and later on in higher classes you will study in detail about the immune system, how it works. So, but here also you have to be aware of different players of the immune system. So first of all, you should understand that how this immune system is evolved. So immune word is a Latin word. It means to exempt. Means anything which is foreign to our body, which is not belonging to our body. If it is entering inside our body, so our body has to remove it. So it is not going to allow. For this permission or permission of entry or not to permit, that all depends on the barriers we have. So we have variety of barriers, so which are some are physical barriers like our skin and mucous membranes. So they are going to deal with any microbe which is entering from outside. So our body is going to grab it and kill it. If these physical barriers, maybe the temperature of our body, like, and the tears, they contain different enzymes, lysozymes, which can kill the microbes. So if these physical barriers, they are unable to kill the invaders, then our immune cells has to play important roles. So you all are aware about the blood. So here, why I am talking about blood, because after crossing the physical barrier, so you all know that all the portions of our body is supplied with the blood vessels, because our body, all the tissues, in fact, they need the nutrients and oxygen and everything. So blood is a main vehicle to carry the nutrients as well as the oxygen, and they take up the nitrogenous waste from our tissues to from the tissues to the blood. So here the purpose is of the blood cells is to recognize these invaders, right? So first of all, you all should remind how many type of blood cells are there. You did in your practical classes also, you might have seen the type of blood cells, and so we all know that blood is made up of cellular content and fluid content. So here we are talking about the cellular content. So blood cell types, blood contain three type of cells, or when you call cellular content. So they are first type or are RBCs, red blood corpuscles, then WBCs, white blood corpuscles, and blood platelets. So you all know about them and their function. So RBCs, red blood corpuscles, they are red because they contain hemoglobin for the transport of oxygen. You all are aware of it. WBCs, they are also called as leukocytes, or white blood corpuscles because they don't contain any color pigment, because their function is totally different. They are meant for the defense mechanism, and blood platelets, they are meant for the blood clotting. So here in present topic, we are going to deal with WBCs only, because WBCs, they contain different type of cells which are involved one way or other in the immune system. So now we can see the details of the WBCs. So WBCs, they are both myeloid and lymphoid progenitors. You all understand what are myeloid progenitors. Neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils, they are myeloid progenitors. Lymphocytes, monocytes, they are lymphoid progenitors. And here we say these two type of WBCs. In fact, we should remove this blood from here. We should put WBCs or leukocytes. So one type is A granulocyte without granules, and second type is granulocytes. A granulocytes contain two, they are lymphocytes and monocytes, whereas granulocytes are of different kinds, like neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils. So three types you have studied in your classes. So now you, and these lymphocytes can be divided into further. So these are B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. So we all know that all the blood cell types, whether they are RBCs, whether they are WBCs or blood platelets, they all originate in the bone marrow. That is, the progenitors or stem cells are present in the bone marrow. So after origin, they mature in some other places. Okay, so these granulocytes and agranulocytes, for them you can understand, these lymphocytes, monocytes, they all originate in the bone marrow, but the site of maturation for the B and T lymphocytes are different, and others, they mature in the bone marrow itself. So B lymphocytes, apart from origin from the bone marrow, they mature also in the bone marrow, whereas T lymphocytes, they mature in the thymus. They are named because it was studied for the first time in the birds. So on the basis of birds of Fabricius, they mature in the birds of Fabricius in birds, so it is called B lymphocytes, and they mature in the thymus, so they are called as T lymphocytes. And monocytes, they are, you know their structures. Monocytes, they are bean shaped structure, and they occupy most of the cytoplasmic area. Their nucleus is bean shaped. Okay, neutrophils, you might remember, their nucleus is in different forms, 2 to 5 to 7 lobes, and they contain granules in the cytoplasm. Eosinophils, they are smaller cells, and they are bilobed cells. They contain two lobes in their and these two lobes are joined together by a thin strand called isthmus, and they are also granulocytes. Okay, basophils, they are smallest one, they are horseshoe shaped nucleus containing cells, and they are also granulocytes. So these cells are very less. Basophils are 0.3%, they are also 5 to 10% in blood, they are 3%, and these are 60%, and these lymphocytes are all 30 to 40%. monocytes are also less. So this is the type of blood cells which are playing important role one way or other in the immune system. So after this, now we are aware what type of cells are involved in the immunity. So two more cell types I will tell you. First, you should also understand about these monocytes, because these monocytes, they are present in the blood, but when they reach to the tissue sites, they are named differently. Their name is different. So they are called as macrophages, and their function is also different over there. So in the blood, they are monocytes, and when they reach to the tissue sites, they become macrophages, and they are very important cells in the immunity or the forming the immune system. Okay, so now major players. Of immune system. I told you different blood cell types, they act as major players. So first, we will talk about first innate immunity and then adaptive immunity. And then we'll include the type of cells which are involved in the immunity. As I told you earlier that our body has variety of barriers to deal with the infection. So innate immunity therefore is called as the immunity which is present by birth, or it is non-specific. Means any type of barrier, any type of a physical attribute which are present in the body, they can check the entry of the microbe. But adaptive immunity, specific cell types are involved in the adaptive immunity. Okay, so that is that, then you can call it more specific. This is a specific type of immunity. Okay, for today I am stopping here, and next we'll talk in detail about the innate immunity and the adaptive immunity. Thank you.